John Dalton was a humble 18th century scientist, most famous for his work on atomic theory and color blindness. He was born on September 6, 1766, in a small town in England to a family of poor Quakers. He was an exceptionally bright child. And at the age of just 12, he was put in charge of his local Quaker school. At 15, he moved to Kendal to teach. The city was not as cosmopolitan as London, but it was a big town to Dalton. When he moved there in 1781, he saw an umbrella for the first time. So he bought one. And then he said, "Now I'm becoming a gentleman." As an instructor, he was all about the math. Sometimes he could get so preoccupied with mathematics, he wouldn't even notice the kids misbehaving, even when they were throwing pieces of paper at him. In Kendal, he met his mentor, John Gough, who was a blind English philosopher and scientist. He taught Dalton the importance of diligence and hard work. And Dalton himself once said, "If I have succeeded, it is not so much from any superior genius, but more from attention to study and perseverance." Dalton then brought his diligent sensibility to Manchester in 1793, where he embarked on a number of intellectual works, many of which were inspired by observations he made in his own life. Like the time Dalton thought he was buying his Quaker mother a pair of conservative black stockings, when in fact they were bright scarlet. And this is, of course, how Dalton realized he was colorblind. But back then, they didn't call it that. They didn't call it anything because it wasn't yet part of the medical and scientific lexicon. In fact, Dalton was the one who investigated it further, and in 1794 published a paper called "Extraordinary Facts Relating to the Vision of Colors." His paper brought colorblindness to the attention of the medical community, and for many years, it was even called Daltonism, after Dalton. Dalton never married, but he was fully devoted to his work. He kept a meteorological diary in which he noted the barometric pressure, wind direction and velocity, rainfall, and other details of the weather every single day for 57 years. That's love. His weather journal got him interested in the atmosphere and inspired him to look closer at the properties of gases, which led him to a theory on gas pressure and mixtures, which we now call Dalton's Law. His greatest contribution to science came in the form of his revolutionary atomic theory, which in short pointed out the essential properties in atoms, like their size, weight, mass, and others. He published all these findings in 1808 in a two-part book called A New System of Chemical Philosophy. His work gained acceptance in the science community, and he quickly became the most famous scientist in England. But he never got too big for his britches. He continued teaching and researching until he died on July 27, 1844 in Manchester. Dalton's legacy would live on through his work, inspiring advances in atomic theory for years, and reminding us that the biggest achievements don't always have to come from the biggest personalities.